history. They do not have to try and rewrite history yet once more.
A minute, Tenny, and a fairly bloodless clear. But look, there's still a body on the top floor of Heroic. They still have someone on that really far loose roam in a position where they might be able to close down. So Rogue have to go short, sharp, and they're going to try that. Piranha's going to see if they can stick it. There's nobody in a position to try and stop this as they're buried in dirt. Leon's keeping them a bit at bay, and we find ourselves in a post-plant situation, trying to slip their way back towards the side, but it's Aces is able to lock it off from the opposite side. And I said Durza was on a bit of a loose roam here, and now he's the only one left, and they seem well aware. They saw an opportunity, they saw a pocket of space, and they stuck the plant down in and amongst the mix of it. Finds the first, a spray over the top of Crying, who was just keeping the verticality under control, but with 20 seconds left, and still a lot of players cannot truly drop that hot hatch because you know there's going to be a split of angles either side. Probably not going to be gifted by the chance to shoot them. Either way, the pop of the C4 above wants to force them into a more uncomfortable situation, but we find ourselves here careening to a very quick Rogue first round. A bit more width for that C4. Doesn't quite get it, not entirely sure.
He got killed. Durza got killed as he tossed out the Nitro Cell, and that means he's not going to be able to make anything happen with it. Shukri gets a single kill. Blaz on a flank, however, with an important kill, is going to be taken down one, but he instantly gets traded out. It's only up to Kioxis now, but he got the Diffuser down, I believe. It gets picked up by Aces, who's going to go for the hunt as Leon gets hunting as well, but he gets the kill instead. The M59 not helping it. They have Aces beating up his camera again as the entire Rogue squad just goes for it. And now he has to readjust every single time. Now Aces is going to be trying a hold of the angle into the A bomb side, but the rest is trying to go for the execute. Crying, Leon, Gids will both pick up a kill, but the diffuser has been dropped. They need to go for the pickup, but there's a member down on the main stairs. That is going to be the major threat here, but also the player that's right behind the shield. It's going to be Crying that gets picked eventually. Got the team kill on Prano, actually. Wasn't even a down.
He's suffering from guns this time rather than grenades
below.
Still trying to find a way through, but as you said, Durza is below. Voy is doing everything they can to hold on for as long as possible, but Aces actually gets the drop on Durza. Time's isolated and cut off, and now 30 seconds left. They drive their way up the stairs, caught in the animation of standing up, pulls it out of their legs. They lay down to make sure they don't get shot. 20 seconds, and a 3v4 Prano. Quite injured, and Chaos is going to try and hold in. We're about to have a rotation up on the backside of Red as well. That's going to be the test here on Chaos. Shukri is in a position where they're still trying to open up from the split side. Just caught on the swing round, got the double. Chaos is close in with the shotgun, goes to swing outside, but he's up the red stairs. It's Shukri on the back of the mirror window that they'd put all the way on the far end. Caught from the backside either way. Goes even further, goes for the swing onto logistics, but well, with the body being lost and picked back up on the swing there on the opposite side, Aces is suddenly on his shoulder in the push around the corridor. 30 seconds. They've been able to find their way into sight, but they have a lot of caution. They have no real idea where anybody else is. There's somebody backed in on the corner of Jim, which they've just found. Sprayed couldn't quite connect on the kill as they're dropped either side of Chaos. Is dropped there by the pickup on the secondary. Shukri on the construction door is hoping to try and put a bit of pressure now with 8 seconds. They know they can play around the remaining time, but Rips has the cover. There's just the pulse left. Voy is going to slow creep up. Isn't going to try and drop them through the floor. At this point, thought they might be able to catch them, but couldn't quite make it somehow. The two Rogue players have driven themselves in a solid situation, revealed one of them. The spray comes around the corner. Aces is hungry for blood, but they don't massively need to push against this. The pop of the shield will not actually net anybody. Buys himself a bit of a rotation around on the opposite side. Sprays towards them. Can't quite connect. It's Rips to lock it off. And somehow Rogue pull that one back. See either the C4 or the chance of the smokes. There it is right underneath. Caught though in the midst of it. Blaz went for something heroic, but unfortunately couldn't quite make those dots connect. Durza gets one back, and suddenly Leon is already putting that pressure onto Blue, as we talked about before, into Church. Pops over with the pistol, drops it, and suddenly it's that fragging pair going electric.
Trying to save humanity, but instead we ended up with loads of alien threats.
Went and ranked, put on an Ember skin, and tried to spawn peek the virus. Talking of Voy, takes care of Prano very quickly. Very quickly, Prano, I guess, was just sort of lost in dirt. And look at this. Hey, remember when we saw Rogue try and take an opportunity here on the spray through? Well, they're going to see if they can do the same. Blaz inside Blue. Suddenly, everything is a go here. Can Rogue react better towards when they suffered this before? Leon and Shukri find one apiece, and Shukri's been able to drive them into the site itself. Sprays over the top. Suddenly, it's only Aces left. And to be fair, he's had a storm of a game so far. But when you're on the back foot in a 3v1, it does not make it easy. Buried on the backside of Church. They've been able to get that Blue control and everything that they need to see if they can get the diffuser down outside of, as you said, the diffuser itself. rotates around, and as they pick it back up, they buy themselves a couple of seconds. The spray comes through, and they're going to see if they can get a plant. They've gone for a slight adaptation here, and it's just going down behind the third box right about now. The spray on the first, and the chassis goes for one, just gets out of there in time with a bit of a wiggle, and puts themselves in a 2-1. Tries to bait the play on the rotation, sprays through. They're well aware of where it's going to be coming from. One on the left, though, means that rotation's going to get caught off. Voy finds it. Hey, remember that first round when Rogue read the defense being offside? Well, but also all of the holding onto blue as well. He knows his time is kind of severely limited, as we see even more of a stretch of the players. It's a big rotation underneath to oil. Potentially, no, going to swing up their way onto blue with 15 seconds left, though. That's the push, and that's the take.
Oh, no, not like
sprayed
this.
Through. Leon gets the double, puts him in a 3-2. The hop in on the close window, but it's a skeleton key up in the spine.
No time.
Rips is ready to swing onto it, goes for the take. They're going to try and stick the diffuser. The hop over gets it, puts them in a 1-1. Can't quite get the angle. He's too loose, too wide, and just going to get the rotation. Pops a couple of bullets. Storm at the end, and it's a triple kill for Rips.
He made it way closer than it had to be. If he walked one more step towards the left, he would have been able to pick up the kill before he went down.
It's not easy. Blaz is going to hold off to make sure it's safe for as long as he can. Is able to catch one wide as Pirano went for the attempt on the canister there, and it's just sort of an easy pickup. But look at that timer. Look at the situation how we're in. Look at Aces
user
waiting for the drop here on the hatch. Finds the spray, but no! Shukri falls from the heavens, hits the floor from the top. The spray over the top can't quite connect on the gym equipment. Shukri is the one able to lock off a round.
Looks for the fight here.
Uh-oh. Doesn't know Cryan is just close on the angle, or might either way. He knows now, dropped and taken care of just after, puts them in a 5-2. That single loose player wasn't too far away and was sort of ignored as the drone gets caught on the opposite side. There's so much utility, they don't really have the time to take care of it. Leon finds himself one more out of this hatch, out of this opening, keeps continually driving this team, cannot find Shukri, who has been a bit of a stopping force over this past couple of rounds and the step in for Heroic and doing his part, but needs to be able to pull off an ace in the stand-in game here to drive them to level pegging and keep Rogue off of map point. 10 seconds, no diffuser, 4 kills, and Rogue isn't really flirting with the idea of danger. They don't have to, but now they're on map point. Ping is there on the body that's just at the bottom of the staircase. They try and find the catch on that loose side now. The slow creep towards the bathroom and the lock off in the corridor itself just outside is where the fight is, but it's Cryan that locks it off here. Heroic of 5-2. They still have all the confidence that I think two of our analysts have who haven't quite made it back to the desk yet, but they might need to start the running as the pressure comes and the push comes, and Fresh holds his hand up because suddenly he's going to have to be joined by his co-workers, because suddenly Rogue has locked it off here, and you can only assume the hurried run from Jess and Milos is going to be as quick as some of the attacks that we've had this game, but Rogue are the ones that have locked in this victory.